just to save time because they're the same. Basically, we're gonna move on to eyeshadow, so now let's get into it. So the first thing we're gonna use is the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Warm Honey, like the last video, and I'm gonna use this as an eyeshadow base. Today, I will be going in with the Morphe 24-8 Artist Pass Palette. I like this palette a lot. I just got this palette a few weeks ago. I ordered it from ultabeauty.com because your girl quarantining, stopping nobody from online shopping. The first shade we're going to go in with is this hot pink color. It's called Max Volume. I actually tried this out before, and I feel like I want to do this like on camera, but with just a little extra blowing a little with my Morphe M518 brush. It looks like this. It's like fluffy. And we're going to use that. We're going to use the Max Volume color and blend it into our crease. Basically, what you want to do is just cover the whole lid because we're going for a solid color look today. So, yeah. Now that we have the pink on our eyes, blend out the edges. I'm just gonna go into this yellow color. Mix it in with the other, like this mustard color. It's called Get the Spot and Under the Sun. So I'm gonna blend those two together to end up, to blend out the edges of the pink. Yo, look at that top, bro. That's crazy. Okay, so now we're gonna do the part that I wanna do that's extra, that adds a little glam to the look. I'm gonna add rhinestones to my eyelid. Too much, but like I want it to be like spaced out in a way. So I'm just gonna use these rhinestones that I bought off of Amazon. I have a lot of different colors, but today we're gonna use silver. I'm gonna do different sizes. I don't know if I want to do big to small or small to big. I guess we'll just randomly do it. I'm gonna use this super strong hold eyelash adhesive. I would usually use clear, but I don't have clear right now, so I'm just gonna use black because the rhinestones are gonna be covering it anyway. But first, I think I want to outline where I want to put them at. So I'm going to use this skinny brush and I'm going to go in with some regular concealer. And I think I'm just going to draw out the spots, like just tap where I want the spots to be so that I have an idea where I want to put the rhinestones at. And now we're going to go into applying the rhinestones. I've never done anything like this before, so I feel like it'll be really, really fun and interesting. So let's go. I'm very excited to start. So let's start. Okay, so one eye is finished, as you guys can see. I think I'm gonna add some more little rhinestones in the in between. So that's what I'm gonna do right now because it's looking a little spacey. It's cute, but it's looking a little spacey. So now it's time to move on to lashes. So I'm gonna use the same black eyelash glue that I used to apply the rhinestones, and I'm gonna use these lashes I got from AliExpress. I'll definitely put the link below so you guys can purchase if they still have them in stock. So don't buy these, I'll definitely put an alternative below. So yeah, they're not too dramatic, and I don't want the lashes to be too dramatic because I don't want them to take away from the eyelid because the eyelid is very, very dramatic. So yes, but now it's time to move on to the face. So I'm gonna go with my matte putty primer, and then I'm gonna go in with a thin layer of translucent powder. Regular foundation brush to apply this primer. I'll just use this big fluffy brush to apply my powder. don't have my foundation yet, so I'm mixing two foundations today, which is the Maybelline Fit Me Dewing Smooth Foundation 355 Coconut and the Maybelline Dream Ready Liquid Hydrating Foundation in the shade 135 Java. Concealer time. So first concealer I'm gonna go in with is the LA Girl Pro Concealer shade Chestnut. Then following with the color Toffee, same brand concealer. And then following with the last shade, which is Warm Honey. Focusing the lighter shade on the inner corners. And lastly, I'm gonna go in with the Tarte Shade Tint Concealer in the shade Medium Beige, Medium Honey. And I'm just gonna put that in the very, very inner corner. I'm gonna blend all this in with the e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush, very lightly, tapping motion. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in back in with the Dream Radiant Liquid Foundation and just create my contour. And then I'm gonna use this side of the Reblender to blend out everything. Now that the contour and everything's blended out, we're gonna go into the powder. So I'm gonna use this Real Techniques setting brush, which is my favorite brush to apply powder. And I'm gonna go in with the same powder that I used for my primer early on in the video. So for contour, I'm gonna go in with the Morphe 3502 palette in the shade Stone and Toast. These are my go-to contour shades with my angle fluffy brush, and we're going to set that contour. Contour is still a little oily, so I'm just gonna go in with my Reblender and some translucent powder and just set the areas where I've contoured. I'm also gonna use the translucent powder to clean up my nose contour. Sit there just to really cut that nose contour. So while waiting for that, we're gonna do blush now. I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M510 brush, and I'm gonna back into the Morphe 3502 palette, and I'm gonna go with these two orange shades right here. They're called Brick and Blaze, and I'm gonna use that as my blush colors today, okay? I'm gonna go back into the 24 Artist palette, and I'm gonna go back into that pink shade and add that on my lower lash line just to make the eyes pop. I'm gonna go back into the Sephora mascara, and I'm just gonna add it on my lower lash line. And with this brush right here, the one that we used to apply our powder, and I'm just gonna pat the nose, pat the translucent powder around on my nose into my skin. So now what we're gonna do is spray my face with my favorite setting spray, which is the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. So we're gonna spray my face. We're gonna let the setting spray sit. So we're gonna do the lips. And so my favorite lip combo in general are nudes, but this has been my favorite lip combo lately. I use the NYX Butter Glosses in the shade Ginger Snap and Madeline. I use the Ginger Snap as sort of like a lip liner, and then I just fill it in with Madeline and it looks beautiful. I'm gonna go with highlighter. So I'm gonna go in with my Morphe AS Stellar Impact Highlighter Palette, which is my favorite highlighter palette of all time. It's amazing. Oh, by the way, I'm going in with the shade My Ridge. It's like a golden shade, perfect for brown skin. So if you're looking for a good highlighter, I suggest this palette, this oil. So in all honesty, I think this look is complete. But if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, comment, and share, hit that bell. And if you guys like these videos, I definitely bring more to the channel because your girl is a beauty guru. On the raw, if you see feeling. 6 o'clock in the morning right now, so I haven't went to sleep yet. So I'm gonna do this for today. I'm like, yes, I gotta stay dedicated to my peoples. I gotta stay dedicated to YouTube. I wanna do this. I gotta get on point. That's all I want to do, but I hope you guys know this look. I think it's really, really cute, and it's a vibe. Very, very glam, very, very cute. I would definitely wear this on my birthday. I really would. So, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed.